Hello, my name is Mike Bartlett, and I'm the chair of the biology department at Portland State University. Thank you for joining me to celebrate our graduates today. Welcome, family, friends, and honored guests. Welcome, biology faculty, staff, and continuing students. In PSU Biology Class of 2020, welcome and congratulations. Our celebration this year is very different, I know. I wish we could be together in person to do this. Students, I'll miss seeing you in your caps and gowns. I'll miss meeting your parents and other family members and your friends. I'll miss saying goodbye in person. But in the name of defeating the viral infectious cycle, we must, for now, gather around our screens as we recognize and celebrate all of our graduates. I'm very proud of the students, staff, and faculty in the biology department and the outstanding accomplishments I see on a daily basis in our classrooms and laboratories, and with the fieldwork and outreach being done across the Pacific Northwest and indeed across the world. The reach of PSU biology is truly global. It has been a history-making spring term. We have coped with and adapted to the effects of the pandemic caused by the SARS coronavirus 2. This has turned the world on its head and has affected all of us in ways both great and small. We are collectively experiencing the fear of contracting the virus or seeing loved ones harmed by this virus. Some of us have lost family members and close friends. Many have lost their jobs or seen their work severely curtailed. And we've all had to get used to restrictions on our in-person interactions with others, physically distanced for our own and everyone else's safety. And as if a novel coronavirus were not challenging enough, finishing the spring term and finishing your degrees has also been impacted by the social uprisings both in Portland and across this nation, in response to recent as well as long-standing historical injustices to our Black citizens. I know that this time has been particularly stressful for our students, staff, and faculty of color. I know that many of you have been exercising your constitutional right to peaceful assembly and protest. And I want you to know that I see you, I hear you, I support you in your protest. And I stand with you in solidarity. The adjustment of our typical university life to the reality of COVID-19 has been jarring, and yet we have adapted. Between the middle of March and the start of the spring term, our faculty and graduate teaching assistants and staff made a monumental shift of all course materials to the so-called distance learning mode. I had never heard of Zoom until the middle of March. Now it seems like that's all I do, all day long. To our students, I know that this has been an uncomfortable transition and that it's not been the final term that any of you would have wanted. I am proud of you for sticking with it, for the work that you have done, as you have made your way through these last few kilometers to the finish line. The importance of a strong biology degree has only been made more clear with this viral pandemic. We see the immediate value of cell and molecular biology training, both in the sequencing and detection of the virus genome during infection, and in the characterization of the viral protein structures that are guiding development and testing of antiviral medications and novel vaccines. Molecular evolution studies are helping us to understand how the virus is changing or not as it makes its way across the globe. Epidemiological studies help us understand how the virus is spreading and how we can curtail that spread. Wildlife biologists examine animal reservoirs for virus evolution. And health professionals on the front line, many of whom started their careers with biology degrees, put their lives on the line as they comfort and heal patients suffering from the virus. Essentially, all areas of biology are directly relevant for solving this virus problem, and as a result of these and past scientific efforts, we do have a reasonable hope for mitigating this pandemic and ultimately ending it, so that we may return to a normal life with social gatherings and classes back in the classroom. PSU Biology, class of 2020, you have completed your degrees. Wherever your next steps take you, I can't wait to see what you accomplish in this world. Work hard, but keep it balanced. Take care of yourself and take care of others. Stay in touch, and if you're back in town, stop in, let us know how you're doing. And lastly, congratulations.
Hello, I'm Matthew Carlson, Interim Dean of the College of Liberal Arts and Sciences at Portland State University. I'm so pleased to be here virtually to celebrate the biology graduates of 2020. In a typical year, I would congratulate you for your hard work and perseverance in reaching your goal of earning a college degree. Like me, many of you are first-generation college students, our parents, and have worked outside of school while pursuing your education. You worked hard and you sacrificed, and here you are to receive your diplomas, and that's a lot to be proud of. But this is no typical year. All of you overcame extraordinary barriers. Like no others before you, you demonstrated extreme flexibility. You maintained focus as the world changed rapidly around you, and you continued to show up even when it seemed impossible. And I have never been so proud of a group of students as I am of all of you now. Your graduating class, the PSU class of 2020, will be defined by this moment. This is a historical moment that will forever change the course of the future. As you graduate, the country is in the grip of two epidemics. The coronavirus pandemic has forced the entire planet to hit the pause button. This virus has broken down well-established economic, cultural, and social institutions, and it's going to change everything, the way we live, the way we learn, and the way we work. And even as our community struggles with COVID-19, the epidemic of police violence against African Americans has again been brought to the forefront by the recent deaths of George Floyd, Breonna Taylor, and Ahmaud Arbery. At this moment, our city and country are erupting in protest over the ways that racism continues to do harm every day to Blacks in America. We've also learned that the effects of COVID-19 have been more harmful to Black communities and other communities of color. This is also because of structural racism, both because it increases poor health and increases poor access to healthcare. Whether you plan a career in medicine or to work in improving the environment, we are sending you into a new world, one that will need to be rebuilt into a more just, sustainable, and inclusive one. I know you're all up to the task. Class of 2020, you have learned new ways to collaborate, to solve problems, and you will be known as the generation who can successfully adapt to rapid social change and accomplish your goals no matter what the obstacle. So for you, biology class of 2020, I say congratulations for your accomplishments. Thank you for all your contributions over the years you have been here. And I look forward to seeing you in person in the new world of your making.
Hello everybody here from my basement home office. My name is Daniel Bornhorn. I'm a plant chemical ecologist here at PSU. In my lab, my grad students and I, we are studying the interactions between plants and microbes on the molecular and chemical level, and we're trying to understand how feedback loops between these types of organisms affect hyotrophic levels, for example, plant consumers. I teach a variety of classes, including principles of biology, introduction to plant biology, plant chemical biology. And in the fall, for the first time, I will teach mycology, which I'm really excited about. I'm also in collaboration with the chemistry department, I teach the Chem BioCure, which is a lab-based discovery class. At this point, I really just want to wish you all the best for your future. You achieved a lot in these difficult times. And I just wanted to let you know that I would love to stay in contact with you. Maybe you can send me emails once in a while and update me about your endeavors and your careers. And also, at any time, you can also reach out to me and ask me for favors, for example, letters of recommendations. I would be happy to support you also in the future. Again, congratulations. You are great people. I am very excited that I had a chance to meet you. And yeah, I wish you all the best.
Hello, this is Dr. Duffield. I want to add my congratulations to all of you for your graduation. And I wanted most of all to thank those of you I've gotten to meet in my classes and with my internship, and especially those of you that struggled through spring quarter in marine mammals. Your enthusiasm and your hard work really made this a great class. Thank you for that. So to all of you, I send my very best and good wishes for your future endeavors.
Greetings to all you graduates, parents, family members, and friends of our graduating class. I've had the privilege of working with your students in my classes over the last few years. I generally teach the evolution course, plant evolutionary biology, plant reproduction, and evolutionary genomics. You should be extremely proud of your accomplishments. Parents, you should be extremely proud of these students. My experience with PSU students is that they are some of the best students I've ever had the privilege of working with. And within PSU, I think biology students are the best of the best. We all are proud that Portland State University grants more degrees to Oregon residents than any other university in Oregon. And we're also proud of the fact that independent studies show that our graduates have a larger impact on the Oregon economy than any other Oregon university. Our students are special because they come from diverse backgrounds. And I know these are challenging times, but I'm confident that our students, with their diverse challenges that they've had to deal with in the past, are going to be successful in the future. Our students are motivated, hardworking, and resilient. I have every confidence that all of you will do well, and we hope to be able to hear from you in the future. Just know that we will always be here for you. Thank you very much.
Congratulations, class of 2020. My name is Dr. Sarah Epley, and I'm a professor in the biology department, and I am a biologist studying the effects of climate change on plants. I have two different research projects that I primarily work on. One looking at the effects of sea level rises in salt marshes along the Oregon coast. And my other main project looks at the effects of global warming in Antarctica, looking at how the retreating of glaciers in Antarctica affects plants in Antarctica. And I teach a couple classes in the biology department. One of my main courses is the ecology course, the general ecology course, so that's where I may have seen some of you there. And I teach some upper level biology courses as well. So I teach plant ecology, I teach community ecology, and I teach a course that's focused on how global climate change affects plants and how plants affects global climate change. And as you go out into the world, I hope you use the science you've learned here at PSU to affect how we deal with climate change. And you're the generation that's going to be working on these issues along with us. And I'm very excited about our prospects with this. So good luck, class of 2020, and congratulations on your graduation.
Hi, this is Dr. Thomas Hancock. I am the teacher of anatomy and physiology, as well as mammalian physiology. And I'd just like to take a moment to say congratulations to all the undergraduates and the graduate students graduating today. Well done. All the best to you.
Hey everyone, my name is Stephanie Kautz. I am an instructor at Portland State University and I teach Principles of Biology, the entire series. I teach plant systematics as well as plant chemical biology. Some of you were in my classes, and I would like to congratulate everyone on graduating. You all did amazing, particularly this last term was very challenging, so congratulations on that. I also would like to say, please stay in touch. If you were in my classes and we've met, please email me if you have exciting news to share, if you got a job, if you're a teacher yourself, please let me know. I'd be excited to know. And if you need letters of recommendation, you all have my email, so don't hesitate to ask. With that, I would like to wish everyone a happy summer. And again, congratulations, you all did amazing.
My name is Dr. Annie Lindgren. I am a deep sea biologist and professor here in the biology department at Portland State University. I also teach all of our marine and deep sea biology upper division courses. I have gotten to work with so many of you over the last several years, and I so wish that I could tell you and your parents and your families in person how proud you should all be of these amazing accomplishments. This final term at PSU especially has taken extra grit and resilience, and you all have risen to that challenge. I wish you all the best for the future, and congratulations, PSU Biology Class of 2020.
Congratulations, graduates. I'm Susan Masta, and I teach an animal biodiversity course, museum outreach courses, and a variety of evolution-focused courses. Because of the smaller size of some of these courses, I've gotten to know some of you well. It's been amazing to see how thoughtful, creative, kind, and talented you are, and your resolve to make the world a better place. You give me hope for the future. Best wishes on the next part of your life's journey.
Welcome, folks. I'm sorry that I can't be there in person, nor can any of us, but I want to wish my congratulations to all of you in 2020. It's been a big, crazy year, but here we are at the end of it. My name is Michael Murphy, and for those of you who've taken classes with me, you know what they are, but for those of you who haven't, I teach vertebrate zoology, ornithology, population ecology, and I also throw in there natural history of Oregon and bird banding once in a while. My research is about the population biology and ecology of birds, and I've worked with many of you on that, and it's been a blast. Now, don't be strangers. Come back again and visit us, and hopefully we'll all get back to normal pretty soon. Congratulations again.
Congratulations, PSU Biology graduates of 2020. This is Dr. Napier, and I'm your friendly immunology and cell biology professor. I'm so proud of you guys for making it through this biology gauntlet. Nonetheless, during a pandemic and during the second civil rights movement. As you approach your next step, whether it be work or more school or any other endeavors, my advice to you would be follow your gut, be kind to others, and remember to decolonize science. Viva la revolution!
Hello, graduating seniors. My name is Radhika Reddy, and I teach neurophysiology, sensory physiology, and fundamentals of biology here in PSU's biology department. I also work with the Build Exito program that supports undergraduate research both at PSU and at OHSU. And I'm here to say that it is such a privilege for me to be able to work with such a unique and wonderful student population like the one we have here at PSU. I thank you for allowing us to share a little bit of your journey with us and congratulate you on the feat of making it to the finish line. Best of luck, graduating seniors.
Hi, I'm Associate Professor Kim Brown. I teach genetics and comparative vertebrate anatomy. And I just wanted to tell everybody congratulations on your graduation this year. It's been an interesting end to your career at Portland State University. And we're all very proud of the work you've done and look forward to hearing of the accomplishments that you have in the future. I look forward to contributing to this virtual graduation, and I am proud to have been a part of your time here at Portland State University and wish you the very best. Thank you.
Welcome to your virtual commencement class of 2020. I'm so happy for all of you. My name is Dr. Erin Shortledge. I teach principles of biology and scientific teaching. For those of you who remember Emmett teaching you about the nervous system, I thought you might want to see him in person because you can't do that in a non-virtual commencement. So there are some benefits. I know this isn't as you expected it to be, it's not as any of us expected it to be, but it doesn't diminish your accomplishments and your achievements and where you will go from here. So I'm so happy for you. Huge congratulations. And I also want to send a special shout out to my PhD student, Bree Tripp, who is graduating this year with her PhD in biology, specializing in biology education research. And I wish you the best of luck as you move on to your postdoc and beyond. And all of you the best of luck as you move forward in your lives. And please keep in touch. Have a great summer.
Hi, those of you who don't know me, I'm the virus guy, as you can tell by the background. My name is Ken Stedman, professor of biology. I teach molecular biology, virology, and the class that probably would have been the greatest one to take this last term, mutant viruses from hell. Well, I guess we don't need to be teaching that class because of, as you can all see. Congratulations to all of you. You made it. It's not easy being a biology student, I know, even though I wasn't one, and particularly in these times. Real congratulations. I also want to acknowledge the amazing amount of unearned privilege that I've had as a white male, and those of you who are not in that condition, even more. Congratulations. Go forth, do good things, and make us proud.
Hey, I'm Justin Crusell. I'm a cancer biologist by training. Got my degree from Stanford University. Spent some time in Paris. I teach our intro genetics course, a microbial engineering course, a grant writing course for our graduate students, and a primary literature reading, how to read the scientific literature. I just wanted to say congratulations to all our graduates, especially Sierra Smith, Cheddar Hoff, Annie Hollingsworth. I miss seeing you guys around in the lab, but I'm sure you're finding ways to cope just like I am, and I hope to get to see you soon. Congratulations to everybody.
Good afternoon, guest, faculty, family, and of course, the 2020 graduating class of Portland State University's Biology Department. My name is Alonso Delgado, and I am truly honored and privileged to be your 2020 student commencement speaker. I want to start off by congratulating you on this immense achievement, especially during these trying times. So please, take a second and give yourself a round of applause. To get to this point, we've all faced different challenges, from teaching yourself how to learn from home, a global pandemic, and facing structural systemic racism within our communities. I know there's no way I can condense all of our experiences at Portland State into one single narrative. So, I will instead share my story with the hope it illuminates some of our experiences within the university and our department. In the fall of 2016, I transferred to Portland State University from a community college in Los Angeles, California. I transferred here because the department's website at the time advertised a zoology degree. And having worked at the Los Angeles Zoo, I wanted to become a zookeeper. This degree would have been a clear path to that career, but it was immediately removed when I got here. So I took all the classes anyways. During my first year, I took both bio and chem back to back while working at the RLSB as a barista at Elephant's Delicatessens. I struggled a lot during my first terms. Transferring had taken a huge mental toll on me, and my dyslexia, which I didn't know I had at the time, became worse due to my stress. So at this time, a normal day consisted of chem in the morning, bio class, and then an 8-hour shift. I had absolutely no time to actually study. I did this until I met Dr. Susan Estes, the then director of the Lewis Stokes Alliance for Minority Participation Program, or as we like to call it, LSAM. We sat down for a meeting and I told her about my situation. She told me that working this much was bad for my grades and then handed me a paper to read. I had never read an academic paper, and I had also never heard that working this hard would affect my grades. I was just very used to it. It was normalized to me at that time. This conversation led to discussing career goals, and she told me if I wanted to reach my my long-term goal of becoming some sort of curator either at a zoo or a museum, I would have to obtain a PhD. Not knowing what that even meant at the time, I said, sure, yeah, I'll do that, no worries. Well, I'll start on that. That conversation led me to getting my first paid research position with then postdoc and now professor at Cornell EEB, Dr. Meredith Holgerson. So in the spring, I started to do field work on my days off. That experience was so impactful to me that I knew I could never go back to a non-science job. Over time, I was able to work less as a barista. And because of that, I was able to take late night classes. One of the classes I took was a museum curation class with Dr. Masta and Dr. Ayi Lundgren. This class allowed me to discover what I really wanted to do career-wise, which was working within museums, identifying specimens, and doing outreach. In this class, I had a conversation with Dr. Lundgren, in which I vividly remember asking her about systematic biology. We discussed aspects of her work, and I remember telling her that I had no desire to ever work with marine organisms or to ever use any type of genetics of any sort. She raised her head at me and said, oh. She later informed me and helped me apply to an internship at the Ohio State University that would allow me to learn how to be a systematic biologist. So 7 months later, I found myself returning from Columbus, Ohio, and giving a talk about my research at the Ronald E. McMayer's Symposium. My research centered around the biogeography of the Peterson's cleaner shrimp. In this project, I only used genetic information and coding to resolve this biogeographical question. Much to my surprise, I have returned a full-on marine invertebrate evolutionary biologist. I even started to work with Dr. Lindgren on small projects and outreach. I even gave a talk about deep sea organisms at PSU's Simon Benson Award dinner last fall. In short, the sum of these experiences led me to apply to graduate school. This winter, I was accepted into my top choices, and me and my fiance have decided to spend the next 5 years back in Columbus, Ohio, in the same lab in which I did my internship. There, I'd be working with Dr. Meg Daly on the systematics of sea anemones and the functional genomics of symbiosis and venom. I left a lot out of my story for the sake of time, but I think it's important to acknowledge that we're facing a global pandemic, which will continue to challenge us. During these times, we have to rely on the people around us, whether that means family, neighbors, or reaching out to a faculty mentor to get advice on how to proceed with your next steps in your future. These times will be hard, but we have all gone through classes like vertebrate zoology at 8 a.m. And I think that speaks to our abilities to persevere and push forward. I want to finish off by thanking Dr. Susan Estes for all the help you have given me over the past few years and for running an LSAT program in which I have benefited from tremendously, and for nominating me to do this. Dr. Lindgren, thank you for mentoring me and for being a great advisor and for sharing your knowledge of marine biology with me. And to the rest of the department for always being supportive when needed. To the class of 2020, I want you to know that this degree is more than just the sum of your coursework and proof that you passed population ecology at 8 a.m. It is proof of your perseverance and your willingness to succeed in any circumstance. It is proof that you can do anything you set your mind to. With that, I want to wish you the best of luck in your future. And again, congratulations on graduating, as it is an immense achievement at any time.
Hello, welcome to the 2020 commencement for the Department of Biology at Portland State University. I'd like to start by congratulating everybody that is completing their degree here at Portland State and introduce myself. My name is Jeff Singer. I'm a faculty member here in the Department of Biology, and I wear several hats in that capacity besides the silly one that you see. And one of them is involved in instruction, and I teach several courses here at Portland State. One of them at the junior level is called molecular biology. A second one at the junior level as well is called cell biology. And in addition to that, I teach a senior graduate level course called cancer biology. In addition to instruction, I also am a researcher and have a research lab. And my interests in my laboratory involve understanding mechanisms which determine whether cells can duplicate, which is a cancer biology interest. And lastly, I am also the chair of the Graduate Affairs Committee. And this committee is involved in basically helping students navigate their way through the graduate program and to enable them to succeed in that process. And one of the honors of this position is that I am given the honor to introduce the graduate students that will be receiving their degrees this year, which includes master's and PhDs. And in order to do that, what I would like to do is basically introduce them, which is really just reading their names in this format, and telling you the name of their thesis or dissertation, and then a few words if they were interested in having me do that about what they plan on doing in the future. So in no particular order, I'd like to begin that process and introduce the first graduate student whose name is Nicholas Diaz, who received a master's degree in the laboratory of Dr. Mitch Cruzan. And the title of his thesis is Recurrent Formation, Low Levels of Ecological Differentiation and Secondary Dispersals Facilitate the Establishment and Persistence of Autopolyploids in Uriophyllum lanatum. And he has indicated that his near future goals are to find employment. Second graduate student I'd like to introduce is named Morgan Thompson, who receives her master's degree from Dr. Suzanne Estes. And the title of her thesis is Sensing Malignancy, Expanding Upon Nematode Scent Detection Test. And her comments are that she plans on going to work in the biotech industry. The third student I'd like to introduce is Elizabeth Tripp, who received her PhD from Dr. Aaron Shortledge. And the title of her dissertation is From Theory to Practice, Interdisciplinary Science in Undergraduate Education. And her future plans involve becoming a postdoctoral researcher. Next student I'd like to introduce is Jessica Persinger, who received her master's degree from Dr. Mitch Cruzan. The title of her thesis is Battle of the Buttercups, Investigating Hybrid Zone Dynamics in Ranunculus Species Complex. The next student, Rachel Wilson, received her PhD from Dr. Deborah Luderschmidt, and the title of her dissertation is Energy Metrics and Life History Transitions in Red-Sided Garter Snakes. The next student that I'd like to introduce also is a PhD recipient named Sharon Glazer. She worked in the laboratory of Dr. Luderschmidt again. And the title of her dissertation is Assessing Well-Being of Asian Elephants Through Major Life Events and Transitions. And she has indicated that what she wishes to do is pursue meaningful projects or employment in which she can use her skills, experience, and passions. The next student was a PhD recipient in Dr. Jason Podobsky's lab, Daniel Zajic, and the title of his dissertation is No Oxygen, No Water, The Unique Physiology of Annual Killifish Embryos Across Development. Lastly, the last student I wish to introduce is a master's degree recipient from Dr. Luis Reyes. His name is Johnny French, and the title of his thesis is Biogeography, Morphology, and Systematics of the Mountain Cottontail. And I'd also like to indicate that all of these students were recipients of the prestigious Forbes Research Award. I'd like to end this by a group congratulations to all these graduate students in completing their degrees. And as a department, we wish you the best of luck. Thank you.
Hi, this is Mitch Cruzan. I'm a professor in the Department of Biology. And as the chair of the scholarship committee I have the honor, the privilege, and the pleasure of recognizing our undergraduate students who are graduating and have completed either an honors degree or have received a scholarship. So first we'll talk about the students who have received honors degrees. Biology students who are members of the University Honors College and biology students who wish to engage in the biology honors program both have to complete a senior honors thesis during the last year or so of their work. During this time, they conduct original research working with biology faculty and grad students. We have a number of students graduating who have completed honors theses. So I will list their names and the title of their thesis. First one is Rachel Bice, who conducted morphological diversity correlates with genetic diversity among populations of Acuracana mollis. Andra Diamond conducted a survey of native bees and their floral use in Portland's urban orchards. Andrew Draper prepared a proposal for comparative morphometrics of Tubingen and Tubingen longfin zebrafish, Danio Rario. Carol Kassab conducted developmental programming effect of maternal obesity. Gabriel Martinez worked on a methodological review of resilience approaches for coral in the face of climate change. Sierra Schmidt conducted prepared a lack of replication disruption following H2O2 induced damage in Escherichia coli. Marissa Swedener conducted research on long-term effects of concussions and the frequency of injury to the different regions of the human brain. Larissa Webster did research on reviewing the potential link between grain-free diet and dilated cardiomyopathy in canines. Jaya Anandakumar worked on screening candidate genes in reduced complexity cross. Lauren Leonard conducted research on the role of a nurse in the end-of-life experience of people who don't have family. Jeffrey Smith worked on the impact of the urban heat mosaic in two Acer species. Coral Bailey worked on behavioral analyses of Zahilophorus californianus and Eumetopius jubatus in Bonneville Dam as tools to understand salmonid take and inform regulation changes. Morgan McAllister worked on cavity nesting solitary wasps in Portland and their use in education research. And Echo Myers did research on a review of antibiotic resistant in the escape pathogens and prospective use in bacteriophage therapy. The Salmon Schulmerich Scholarship is awarded to pre-health undergraduate students in the Department of Biology. And this year we can recognize three graduates who received Salmon Schulmerich scholarships over the last few years. Brooke Sergas, Carol Kassab, and Vi Nguyen. The Lester Newman Undergraduate Research Scholarship supports research for our undergraduates. It was started by Lester Newman, who was a former biology professor. And this year we have graduates who have received two graduates who have received Lester Newman scholarships, Felicia Frizzato and Diana Jemchenko. We'd also like to recognize our PSU Build Exito scholars. Build Exito is an NIH-funded program that supports students from diverse backgrounds who are interested in health research careers. Our graduates this year in who are building Zito scholars include Javier Huerta, Caleb Price, Naomi Sarabia Faria, Nali Setovongsak, and Felicia Zhao. The Lewis Stokes Alliance for Minority Participation is dedicated to supporting the success of students from underrepresented groups who are earning bachelor's degrees in STEM fields of science, technology, engineering, and mathematics. Our Lewis Stokes scholars graduating this year are Kahe Sutton, Javier Huerta, Naomi Sarabia Faria, and Samantha Fancher. Thank you for your attention. Thank you.
good they gave me. I want to say thanks to all my friends and family who have helped me along this journey and who have believed in me. I love you guys. And the class of 2020, we did it!